there's another type of study that I love to cite and talk about because it's a way, as you had mentioned previously, randomized controlled trials are very, very expensive to do. They're very difficult. They take a long time. It's a challenge. So another way of measuring more of a causative role of maybe, you know, of certain factors, and particularly in this case, lifestyle factors, or something that, you know, I call vitamin D a lifestyle because you're making it, you know, from the sun. They're called Mendelian randomization studies. And essentially what they do is they measure, so everyone has, you know, different variations in the sequence of DNA in their genes. And these variations often are just a change in one DNA nucleotide, which is called a single nucleotide polymorphism, or a SNP for short, as you know. But for people listening and watching, there are many different variations in genes that convert, for example, 25-hydroxyvitamin D, the major circulating metabolite of vitamin D, into 1,25-hydroxyvitamin D, which is the active steroid hormone. And these changes in just one nucleotide of DNA in these genes are associated with lower circulating levels of 25-hydroxyvitamin D because, you know, it's just that different genes are doing different things, and sometimes genes get less active and sometimes they're more active based on this, you know, sequence change. So it's well known that these certain SNPs are associated with lower circulating 25-hydroxyvitamin D levels. And so there have been meta-analyses looking at people that have the SNP, didn't measure vitamin D levels at all. It's already known they have lower circulating levels. So you can't say, oh, you know, you're just measuring their low vitamin D, that's biomarking another health status. This is just genetics. We're just looking at a gene that's known to cause that. And these people have a much higher mortality from respiratory tract infections. They have a higher all-cause mortality. They have a higher cancer mortality. Cardiovascular-related mortality is unchanged. But respiratory tract infections are much higher. And so that Mendelian randomization study, I love to cite that because it really is establishing causation, because it's not, you know, you're not just measuring vitamin D levels and then saying, well, maybe they're low in vitamin D because they don't go out and exercise, or maybe they're low in vitamin D because they're, you know, obese and the, you know, vitamin D is less bioavailable, which it is in obese individuals, as you mentioned. So the Mendelian randomization studies are another sort of, in addition to the randomized controlled trials, I think another piece of evidence that hints towards possible causation of vitamin D being important for preventing respiratory tract mortality as well.
Oh, that's amazing. I wasn't even aware of that. That's a great way of showing causation. And of course, they are working on some pilot studies that are trying to show randomization.